Breakthrough transformer-based reinforcement learning AI from Google can learn new tasks in minutes at the level of a skilled human gamer. Google DeepMind has created artificial intelligence agents that can quickly and easily adapt to new situations with minimal interactions, similar to human intelligence, with the goal being to train an agent that can complete exploratory tasks in an unknown environment and continually improve its behavior with very limited exposure. To create their adaptive agent, which is called ADA, DeepMind proposed a method for memory-based meta-reinforcement learning that uses a combination of both reinforcement learning and foundation models. ADA utilizes hypothesis-driven exploratory behavior and the information gained during the task to modify its strategy and achieve near-optimal performance. What's impressive is that ADA has the unique feature of not requiring any offline datasets, prompts, or fine-tuning to accomplish new tasks, and even human studies have confirmed that its adaptation time is comparable to skilled humans. Furthermore, like foundation models in the language domain, ADA can also improve its performance through zero-shot prompting with first-person demonstrations, meaning it can also learn by being shown a task demonstration. DeepMind chose to use transformers as the underlying architecture in order to achieve fast adaptation in context using model-based reinforcement learning, with ADA being trained and tested on the X-LAN2 environment, providing a huge, open-ended 3D world with millions of potential tasks. Because these tasks require various online adaptation abilities, including coordination, experimentation, and navigation, Google's DeepMind researchers implemented what they call prioritized level replay, which is a regret-based strategy that focuses on tasks that challenge the agent's capabilities. The primary components for their training methodology included a curriculum to guide the AI's learning, a model-based reinforcement learning algorithm to train the AI with large-scale attention-based memory, and distillation to enable scaling with over 500 million parameters. Because the agent isn't explicitly given the rules in each environment, it can only understand the underlying rules by interacting with the environment through trial and error, with the difficulty of tasks varying greatly as each set of rules creates unique dynamics. As a result, the artificial intelligence agents must adapt their behavior to successfully complete each task. Amazingly, through a series of experimental evaluations, DeepMind noted that their adaptive agents learn at a human-level speed, and they also discovered that the underlying architecture and use of auto-curriculum learning significantly improved performance. Additionally, they noted direct benefits from scaling elements such as the number of parameters, the size and complexity of training challenges, and the memory length. DeepMind concluded that ADA can quickly adapt to various challenging tasks, including combining objects in new ways, navigating unknown territory, and even using teamwork with partners in coordination-intensive activities. Google says they're excited about the potential for scaling open-ended learning and foundation models to train even more versatile artificial intelligence agents for new tasks in the future. Meanwhile, a breakthrough artificial intelligence diffusion model called Instruct Pix2Pix now allows anyone to effortlessly edit images using written instructions without even needing photo editing software, and it's free. Artificial intelligence researchers from the University of Berkeley have proposed a method of generating a paired dataset using multiple pre-trained models for various modalities. The dataset was created using OpenAI's GPT-3 and a text-to-image model called Stable Diffusion. They then trained a conditional diffusion model on this dataset to produce edited images based on input images and textual descriptions of the desired edits. The AI researchers initially focused on the text domain, using a large language model to process image captions, generate editing instructions, and output edited text captions. Operating in the text domain enabled them to create a wide range of modifications while maintaining a connection between the language instructions and image changes. The AI researchers fine-tuned GPT-3 using a relatively small dataset of editing triplets consisting of input captions, edit instructions, and output captions that were manually created by them. The input captions were selected from the dataset, with 700 samples being used to create the instructions and output captions for the fine-tuning dataset. With this dataset and default training parameters, the GPT-3 model was fine-tuned in a single epoch, leveraging its extensive knowledge and generalization abilities. The researchers then used a pre-trained text-image algorithm to convert two captions into two images. However, text-to-image models often fail to ensure visual consistency, even with small changes to the conditioning prompt, making it challenging to create comparable images from two captions. For example, instructions such as draw a picture of a cat and draw a picture of a black cat could result in vastly different drawings of cats. To address this issue, they employed prompt-to-prompt, a novel technique designed to promote similarity across multiple generations of a text-to-image diffusion model. After generating the training data, the researchers trained their conditional diffusion model called InstructPix2Pix that can edit images based on written instructions. Diffusion models use a series of denoising autoencoders to learn how to generate data samples. Latent diffusion, which is conducted in the latent space of a pre-trained variational autoencoder, improves the effectiveness and quality of diffusion models. To leverage Stable Diffusion's extensive text image generation capabilities, they initialized the weights of the model with a pre-trained Stable Diffusion checkpoint. This was done because fine-tuning a large image diffusion model is more effective than training a model from scratch for image translation tasks, particularly when paired training data is limited. The authors also used classifier-free diffusion guidance, a technique that balances the quality and diversity of samples produced by a diffusion model. The researchers' model can perform zero-shot generalization to both real images and natural human-written instructions, even though it is trained only on synthetic samples. This approach allows for intuitive picture editing that can execute a wide range of modifications, including replacing objects, altering image styles, changing settings, and incorporating creative medium changes. In another recent breakthrough, artificial intelligence researchers from Fudan University and Tencent BDG have created the OMMO dataset, a large collection of outdoor images, point clouds, and annotations that can be used for a variety of tasks such as novel view synthesis, surface reconstruction, and multi-modal NeRF. The dataset was created by selecting high-quality and high-resolution clips from a large number of real flyview videos. The AI researchers used a quality review module to refine the images and remove low-quality frames, and then employed volunteers to add text descriptions for each scene and keyframe. The dataset is unique in that it includes a variety of real-world urban and natural scenes with different scales, camera trajectories, and lighting conditions, making it more comprehensive than existing neural radiance fields datasets. The dataset is a comprehensive collection of indications that includes a variety of scenes, sizes, camera trajectories, lighting conditions, and multimodal data, which surpasses the representation of previous datasets. It provides all-inclusive benchmarks for evaluating the performance of standard NeRF approaches in tasks such as novel view synthesis, scene representations, and multimodal synthesis. Additionally, it offers a straightforward process for creating real-world NeRF-based data from online drone videos, enabling easy expansion of the dataset by the community. To provide a detailed evaluation of each approach, it also includes specific sub-benchmarks for each task, taking into account the different scene types, sizes, camera trajectories, and lighting conditions.